Alors, un grand merci, Rita. One more time, Rita is the official sponsor of my coffee here because each time, you know, you don't need it. I mean, I just want a like. I'm a happy man with a like. Allez, let's try to play with this ce qui structure. Ce qui structure would be interesting to see together. So we've been reaching the 100 likes. I don't know who said that, you know, you can die. Well, I guess I could. Let's go for this structure. What is interesting? How could you, structure that in French with the ce qui? Hein? The idea would be systematically to use ce qui. Remember that. Allez-y. Alors, in that situation, yeah, look, we will structure it in a really, really clear way. So, ce qui, after that, you will put the verb. So, in that case, it's être, d'accord? So, être should be in the third person of the singular. So, ce qui est. And then, the adjective that you will put after will be automatically in the masculine form. D'accord? Ce qui est intéressant. Ce qui est intéressant. So remember to write intéressant. Well, the way you can see on your screen, one R and deux S. Let's be generous with the S. This is the reason why you have this strong, strong s. Intéressant. D'accord. Allez, on continue. What is beautiful? What is beautiful? How do you say that in French? Alors, that's it. And we continue in the same logic. So remember, I told you ce qui, then the verb should be in the third person of the singular est. And remember, after that, the adjective should be in the masculine form ce qui est beau. D'accord? Ce qui est beau. The adjective should definitely always, but it seems that it's okay now. Sundar, remember. Sundar, adjective in the masculine form. Luciana, you don't have any two options. No. It will be always the masculine form. Ce qui est beau. D'accord? Allez, on continue. What is good? What is good? Same logic, continue like that. Merci. Alors, oui, apparemment, everything is okay. Patricia, be careful, because Patricia, I was explaining the fact that each time in these structures, you should definitely always put your adjective in the masculine form. D'accord? Ce qui est bon. Ce qui est bon. Ashley, quoi de neuf? I don't know what. What do you want to ask, Mister? Hein? Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Monsieur? Alors, let's go for the next one. Now, look, we start to structure and to have some longer sentences. What interests me makes me passionate. What interests me makes me passionate. How could you structure this sentence? Go for it. Alors, in that situation, it's always interesting to see how to translate because in, well, we can have many options, I guess. I would personally go for the simple way, like with the verb. We have a verb and passion is a verb. So, I think it would be more simple to go for this structure. Ce qui m'intéresse me passion. Alors après ça, well, let's look at some of you went to go passionné, rendre passionné. It's a bit too heavy because in most of the cases we will go for the verb if we have a verb and we can try to make it simple if it's possible, like some persons in the group like that. So ce qui m'intéresse me passion would be the best and most simple option. D'accord? Remember that in that case, the verb is passionné first group, so definitely you should conjugate it in the third person of the singular. Ce qui m'intéresse me passionne. Regardez, what saddens me makes me weak. Attention, what saddens me makes me weak. Allez-y. Alors, I can see that it's a bit more tricky, apparently. I don't really know if... Alors, let me check. So. Here it's quite interesting. Apparently, you will discover some new things. And I'm really happy for you. So, there is a verb, and the verb, it's attristé. Attristé. So, in some cases, you wanted to go for faire triste. We don't use faire triste. We could use rendre triste would be an option, but same thing here. Rendre triste, it's a bit heavy. I mean, we have the verb. Hein? The verb is attristé. Attristé, in that case, it will be from the first group. So, ce qui m'attriste, ce qui attriste moi, hein, ce qui m'attriste me rend faible. We could even go for another verb that is affaiblir, but I didn't want to go too far. So, ce qui m'attriste me rend faible. Or then we could say, ce qui m'attriste m'affaiblit. affaibli, remember, it will be a verb from the second group. So in that situation, maybe this one would be the most simple option. It's a bit tricky, the structure, and I know that it might be difficult. Spiritual Weapons is saying, trop difficile pour moi. Well, don't worry, Spiritual Weapons, only one more, d'accord? Only one more, and here it is. What doesn't interest me bothers me. What doesn't interest me bothers me. Try to make me a sentence with that. Merci beaucoup. Alors, Ashley says, I never saw the verb attristé. Well, it's my pleasure now. It's my pleasure, my little gift to you, Ashley. Voilà, monsieur, I'm offering you a new verb. You can use it like tu m'attristes. Or then, cette situation m'attriste. So, me rend triste. After that, you can brag about the fact that you know this beautiful verb. Okay, let's have a look at the sentence now. Ce qui ne me plaît pas m'ennuie. Alors, you went for m'intéresse, ouais. No problem about that, I could accept. Hein. Ce qui ne m'intéresse pas. Alors, bother, it's really ennuyé. Hein. Me dérange, Sundar went for déranger. Déranger, it's a bit more like to disturb, disturbs me, but we could accept it. If you really want to stick to the translation of to bother, it's ennuyé, d'accord? Déranger, we could agree on that. Cosmina Bellou went for m'embête. Oui, embêté would be a good option too. It's a bit more spoken, hein? So ennuyé would be a bit more formal, a bit more standard or correct. Let's have a look at the thing. So Kirill had ennuyé, so it's good. Hilario, well too. Bah écoutez, félicitations. Merci beaucoup pour cette participation. C'est très très gentil.